alkali regarding alcohol abuse is associated with increased risk of ischemic stroke in low-risk patients with non-valvular atrial fibrillation. Please.
Thank you. Distinguished chairman, faculty, and dear audience, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to give this talk before I present my abstract on Monday. I'll be very concise in this, and you'll get more information and detail when you see the poster. This is work of me and my colleagues at the Karolinska Institute in Stockholm. And there are no relevant interests to declare. Well, about the background of this study is that atrial fibrillation leads to a five-fold increase in the risk of ischemic stroke. We're talking about ischemic stroke. And this risk is not homogeneous. Also, the risk increases when you have other factors like increasing age, like you have female gender, when you have other risk factors like clinical risk factors like hypertension, heart failure, prior stroke, and diabetes mellitus. So this is the basics of the CHA2DS2-VASc risk score, which we use to assess the risk of getting of future ischemic stroke in patients with atrial fibrillation. And this is the basis of how we decide to give anticoagulation or not. There's a point for each of these factors. 1 point, according to the recent guidelines, you have to consider giving anticoagulation. If two, you have to give anticoagulation. But if you don't have any of these factors, then you have CHA2DS2-VASc 0 or CHA2DS2-VASc 1 if you are a woman. And in this case, you have very low risk, minimal risk to get a cerebral stroke, ischemic stroke, and then there's no need to give anticoagulation according to the guidelines. But in clinical practice, we see patients who are under 66 years old who are CHA2DS2-VASc 0 or 1 if they're a woman, because gender as gender female is not enough to give anticoagulation. We have to have another risk factor. We see patients who suffer ischemic stroke even though. And that's why we try to look at the incidence and the predictors and related mortality of ischemic stroke in this low-risk group, which we call CHA2DS2-VASc 0 or 1, CHA2DS2-VASc for men, 1 for female, using a Swedish, the Swedish nationwide hospital registries, because we have, they are linked to a unique personal number for each resident in Sweden. And we use the Drug National Registry, which is complete, covering each prescription in all of Sweden. And we use a database for health insurance and labor market studies to look at the socioeconomic factors. And we could identify 25,252 low-risk non-valvular atrial fibrillation patients at the age of 18 to 24 out of total 345,123 AF patients. And we did a follow-up for 5 years in the period between January 2006 and 2012. So this is a retrospective registry study. And when we look at the results, we saw that the median age of these low-risk patients, the mean age was 55, and most of them were male, 72%. We saw that we found that the ischemic stroke risk in this low-risk population was 3.4 per 1,000 patient year. And we did a multivariate analysis looking at all the clinical factors in the registry. We look at the ECD diagnosis for hospital admissions or if the patients went to a hospital, one of the outpatient clinics. These are the diagnoses from the hospitals. And we saw there were two main predictors beside age, increasing age, increased risk of ischemic stroke, alcohol-related hospitalization, that patients who were admitted or they came to one of the outpatient clinics related to the hospital for an alcohol-related disease, they had a double risk of getting an ischemic stroke. And also we found that the mortality was very high in these patients who got a stroke when compared to patients who did not get stroke. Another finding in this study also, 27% of the patients, even if they were low-risk patients, they had anticoagulation. The cardiologist or GPs, they decided to give them anticoagulation. And we found that there was a lower risk for ischemic stroke in this in this low risk group, which should not really get anticoagulation. And this is something which we have to look further. And of course, we have to look at the bleeding risk as well. We have looked at the bleeding risk in this population, but we will not give them. This is not the topic of this abstract this time. So the conclusion of our study is that a previous hospitalization with an alcohol-related disease was associated with significant increase in the risk of stroke among low-risk non-valvular atrial fibrillation patients. And we need more research to look at this thing, this relation. Of course, we don't know. These are diagnoses for patients who went to the hospital. We think it's only the top of the iceberg. Many of patients who have alcohol problems, they don't come to the hospital. So these are very severe alcoholism, or we have patients who have severe problems, big problems with alcohol, which we could identify in the registry. So I think that alcohol abuse should be penetrated in the clinical practice. We have to ask the patients how much they drink, and there are indications for increased risk, increased mortality, increased ischemic stroke. So we have to warn the patients and to avoid excessive drinking because there are indications for increased morbidity and mortality in this low-risk group. Thank you.